much of an advantage is a couple of milliseconds?
The simple fact is the world is trillions of times more complicated than we experience it. If you experienced everything when you were crossing a street, you would never get across the street.
A couple of milliseconds.
We have to cut it down to a manageable entity.
Entity.
A filter bubble.
1/1,000,000,000th of the information that hits your eye actually gets transmitted to the brain.
You don't actually see what gets edited out.
It's less than 1/1,000,000,000th of reality that we exist in.
That you live in online.
A couple of milliseconds.
When you perceive something, you have 1/10 of a second before it becomes conscious, and it will change in that 1/10 of a second.
We don't all see the same Google results.
Fit what you already believe.
Networks mimic the human brain.
The rich see already a different internet than the poor.
Without knowing it, we're surrounded by this array of personalized filters. It's almost a membrane that sits between us and the world.
If you want a chance to show an ad to a person meeting this specific criteria, tell me how much you are willing to pay and do it in less than 10 milliseconds.
All ideas are physical. The facts will either be ignored, ridiculed, or attacked. They just don't see it.
We have to do it. We have to focus on those few things that are important to our survival. It's an illusion, but it's an illusion that we've all constructed so that we can live.
You know, you sort of step 2 steps to the side to get a better view on something, to get a different angle, and the world turns to meet your gaze.
Jane Doe clicks on a URL. Publisher sends available information. It is stored on Jane Doe.
Entity.
Jane Doe's browser pulls ad from winning bidder's ad server and sends matching ad to browser. And that is 200 milliseconds.
It's all about milliseconds.
It doesn't feel like we're thinking.
Producing up this episode, just sort of getting this, you know, live radio. Well, live radio and live streams, you know, the chats are live.
Yeah.
These things that are live. Negative Land has been rehearsing a little bit online, and the crazy thing about rehearsing online with all this latency is that it still actually feels like live music. Even with the profoundly psychedelic state of knowing full well that every single musician's contributions to the mix are being heard by each of those musicians in totally different relationships and time, that only makes you listen harder in a way. And so Negative Land has been working towards some actual live stream presentations in which we've been hanging out online and just kind of playing and rehearsing. And one of them was accidentally recorded. It occurred to me as I was playing back, hey, wait a minute, that's this week's show. It's not live, but it is a mix. So there's going to be a lot of that, then some alternate mixes of things from recent days, then some sounds, and then the final hour will be a recording of Negative Land from November 2019 in Wrocław, Poland. A recording that was too distorted for us to include on our last live album, Live Brain. So, that'll be the final hour. That is to say, skip ahead in the MP3 that you're playing back right now, because you're insane if you're listening to this over the air. FYI.
Stay angry. Do I sound like I am from 1974?
No, you sound like that missing concrete from 1963.
I sound like missing concrete from 1963.
Yeah. I'm just kidding. I don't know what I'm talking about.
David, is that coming through any better? That's me, those little snappy.
That's very clear. Yeah, that's louder than your voice.
On your end, I don't want to be too loud. I just want to mix in with John at a nice level. So does that
actually, you know, that we'll roll little with it. Sound you're making, Mark, could actually probably run lower because it's very distinctive.
Once we get playing again, John, why don't you let me know overall if my levels seem too loud overall or what? Just give me some feedback as we go. I think my overall goal is just to be listening and trying to be as subtle as I possibly can. And hope that more or less works. Because I'm thinking, particularly because this is more like radio, volume has nothing to do, there's nothing, being loud doesn't matter. There's no one listening to this in the concert hall, there's no big sound system. It's just about whether or not the sound, even if you hear the sound faintly, if it's in there, then it's there.
It went with a sports Walkman, a yellow one, and I took it out with the family radio and walked all over Berkeley with it.
Right. The best way to monitor over the edge wasn't by using station headphones.
Yeah, and I also got in the Monarch and drove around and did it that way. Absolutely no latency whatsoever. It was perfect.
And I like the broadcast noise. If it was a stormy night,
I
and
do
you,
too.
You had a little, yeah, that was the best.
Remember
feeling.
My comment I put on your post? I would have rather heard that BBC broadcast on an SDR radio rather than the sterile sound of streaming. You do
That's
know what
great,
I mean,
David.
Don't you?
That'd be great. If you were speaking to the audience, yeah, that's a great line. You're listening to the sterile sound of streaming because the algorithm wants it that way.
Yeah, it does. You're right. You know, it's compressed. It's like, you know, 128 MP3, and very, very super dry sounding. And I don't like that. It hurts my head. Well, my internet came back, but it won't allow me to connect to the service that way. It only shows it's working, and that's all it's going to do.
David, are you set up? Are you set up to mix with us with some sounds if we just start to playing a little bit?
Absolutely not. I'm just set up on my tripod in my kitchen. It's not worth it to try to do it with it this bad.
Okay.
It, you know, this will force me to call Comcast and buy that damn phone.
Do you like electronic music?
I think this... right now, I don't think so. I'm kind of mad at it.
I suppose part of the performance could just be David talking about how nothing's working right and he's not going to perform with us.
To this beat.
So I need you guys to send me something that I can study, and then I could write down some stuff on pieces of paper like I did for the tour you did. I had several pieces of paper. I had it right on the tripod, and I could refer to it.
Well, David, can we try something with a beat?
So bad.
And can you just try some vocal stuff just about the things you're thinking about while John plays a beat?
If you want to.
Sure. Yeah. Absolutely.
Before we start, has my voice been consistently the same level all the time? Pretty much right
yeah,
now.
I'm not
one,
noticing.
One, two, three, four, five. I'm just kind of moving around. I'm about 15 inches from the phone, and I'm moving my head around while I'm talking. So is it steady?
Yeah, it doesn't change. I don't hear anything.
Yeah, I'm getting...
What was that, John? What are you
getting? It's a frozen... I'm getting about one new frame update every 3 seconds.
He was wondering about his volume of his
exactly
sound level.
That's exactly right. Yeah, that's something I cannot control. Now I have my nice sure microphone, but this phone won't let me use it on this type of a transmission. It only works on streaming.
Those bastards.
So I'm hoping the new phone, since it doesn't have a headphone jack, everything should go through the USB 3, which is, you know, it's a very powerful, that's the most latest connector that can have all sorts of devices on it. So I'm hoping it'll work with my Mackie mixer and the whole nine yards. But yeah, this phone has seen its day, and the other day, I dropped it on the linoleum. I don't think I scratched it, but I dropped it.
That sounds like a great idea for a piece.
Damn thing.
And this my phone? I dropped it.
On the linoleum.
Luckily, the linoleum, since it's kind of smooth, it didn't scratch it. It didn't do it. It looks brand new.
Okay, well, we're currently performing right now, so this is all the vocals
yes,
you're doing.
Yes, I understand.
Okay, keep
going. I understand.
Going.
I'm trying to get it. Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I dropped my phone the other day on the linoleum in my kitchen. Now, I thought it was going to be broken, but no, I picked it up and not a scratch. Not anything. It looks brand new. So I don't know. And then my internet connection is all screwed up. On my older iPad, I can speed test, and I'm getting, you know, over 30 megabits. That's on the download, and on the upload, it's about 12 megabits, which is the maximum that Comcast allows. So it seems like it's working there, but on the phone, it just drops away, and sometimes it won't even measure. However, when it does measure, I can get maybe about 26 megabits on the download on my phone when it's working, but it isn't always working. And again, on the upload side on my phone, on the Wi-Fi, it gets the maximum, about 12 megabits. But then sometimes it just drops away and it won't test at all. I don't understand. It's very confusing. For some reason, my left eye is watering right now. I don't know why. I'm going to dip a little more. I'm going to dip into my coffee. So now I'm not sure what I'm going to do, except I guess I have to call Comcast.
Hold on, David. You got real loud there for
yes,
just a
I'm
second.
Holding.
That was better. How did you get louder for a second? You were louder.
I didn't change anything. I'm
you got
just
a little
same
louder.
Distance. I'm, Yeah. I don't know. Is it still louder or did it drop back again?
You kind of dropped down. The thing is, in the mix right now, you're a little hard to understand relative to John's volume.
Well, so, he sounds great to me.
Okay, does that help?
Yeah, unfortunately,
I think the only mix that's going to matter
is going to be the one going out from here. But I have to talk to Jennifer about that. She's not here right now. She's out in the yard gardening.
Okay, well, we do need to know what the reference monitor is. We need to know that because I've just compensated here so that you're not ear-splittingly loud. David is fine. David sounds great to me.
Where is this reference monitor? Where actually is it? Is it with Jennifer? Is that it?
Well, here's what I don't understand is I'm assuming that the mix I'm hearing is the mix that goes out if Jennifer's sending out everything to the festival. But I don't... John is able to create a different... John's mix out there is different. I don't know why. Do you know why, John? It'd be so different?
No... No, I don't. We need a sense of reality because, we do need on a separate phone or whatever. That sounds like a good idea. You know, we're going to need something similar to that. You know, like I can only play to what I have.
Well, I'm wondering. Geez, yeah, I'm wondering how. If what we want to do is send out a mix that sounds like the mix you have, John, and I don't know how we could do it.
I don't know how we would do that.
And I'll bet Jennifer has a better internet connection, too. That's important.
Well, let me go see. I think she may be outside on a phone call. Let me go see if I can find her.
No. There's no need.
Both of you sound pretty even and balanced coming back to me and very clear. No dropout at all.
And you're hearing this in mono or stereo?
It's mono, even though these headphones I know are stereo. It's just coming in mono.
I'm getting Mark in stereo.
Can one of you do hard panning left and right and let me see if I can tell?
I'm left, I'm right.
It's just staying right in the middle. You don't have to do any more. No change whatsoever. Not even a change in the volume level when you pan. It's centered right in the middle.
Not even any phasing artifacts as I pan?
No, nothing.
As I go through center pan? Oh, well.
You're at 0 degrees.
The pan laws are so accurate, it must be ducking negative 3 dB as it passes through center perfectly.
Whatever it has to do, it's perfect. It's staying centered, absolutely perfect. No phase shift in mono either, which I know I could tell if it was there. It's not happening. It's perfect.
That's something for our audience to know if you ever want to mention that. There's no phase shifting at all as wobbly pans from left to right. None.
Okay, these are... I'm going to... After we're done later tonight, I will start writing stuff down because I can't remember this stuff. And when I was angry last night talking with Mark, I said some good stuff too, and I can't remember it.
Well, it was kind of like he was transposing the ideas of certain men and failure, but he was making it be all about the algorithms. And I thought there was some potential there.
I was, I guess, substituting algorithms or men with algorithms and just seeing if I could work with that. And a little bit of Republican gay bear thrown in, too.
Why are gay algorithms Republican?
Yeah! Well, I have to admit, you guys are inspiring when I'm hearing it so clear. It's really nice to... And it's 1 megabit I'm getting this on. So something's working right. But we're supposed to have some snow here. And when it snows, people like to sue. So someone's going to deliberately fall down in front of my house in the snow and sue me out of existence.
That's a Republican talking point, David. Are you more than just a gay bear?
It might be.
No.
Are you going alt-right on us?
That reminds me of the sound of people slipping on the snow in front of my house and suing me.
You know, almost like the eclipse we almost had the other day.
The left
wants
to take away your solar
eclipse. I wonder what the resolution of these still frames are coming back. It's sure clear. But I don't know why.
What does
Wi-Fi, what, good, even though it's working a little bit, it's rejecting anything to do with streaming. It just turned itself off as soon as I tried. But yet
you don't have your
computer.
Yeah, but you don't have your computer up right now, do you?
No, the computer is too weak to do this at all. It doesn't do anything.
I'm just curious.
And the internet connection. Since the computer doesn't have LTE, it'd be on the weak Wi-Fi. It wouldn't do a damn thing.
I'm just curious as to what Google would autocomplete if you started typing in the sentence, the left wants to take away your.
I'm afraid to do that. They might send the police.
Well, what does Google think? You're trying to find out what the left is trying to take away from you.
I don't know, but it's not good. That's all I can say.
Well, we'll have to find that out later.
We'll just go to Google and type in the left wants to take away more.
And we'll see what Google thinks the last word in your sentence is.
I'm probably getting a little senile, really, when it all comes down to it, because I'm making more typos all the time when I'm trying to respond to people on social media. And I have to go back and correct myself and then write the word damnation in all caps. And I still make mistakes. What's that clicking sound? Who's making that? Oh, okay. All right, I see. You're both sounding great, my God.
That's just because we have all this weird stuff in front of us that just makes all these funny noises.
You know, you've probably seen the news broadcasts where people are calling from their living rooms. Some of them sound really awful. You guys are sounding just like you're here. It's remarkable how great it's sounding. There's none of that problem with the... You go ahead, John.
It's very over the edge.
Yeah, it's on these little headphones. Boy, it sounds good. Just, I wish it was in stereo, but I'm hoping the new phone... Now, if I order it tomorrow, it'll probably be here before next week.
Well, it sounds like that's the thing to do.
I just hope my credit card company doesn't think that it's too much money. They did that once when I spent a lot of money. They declined the card, even though I had enough money to cover it. Now I'm confused. There's four images, or are there? Mark, is it a full width? I see. Is there two images of Mark?
Mark put a green screen,
something
extra face. His face is over superimposed over the close up of his.
Jennifer did this. Just
that.
So that way you can see.
It's
his
perfect.
Face.
There's I don't see any artifacts or anything. Yeah, boy, that looks good. I should take a screenshot. At least the phone will do that. Yeah, you guys look wonderful. I am. Okay. So on the left hand, I see Mark's hands, and on the right side, I see your face. But then the full width of the picture seems to be all your stuff in addition. And it's perfectly clear. Take another screenshot. I'm sorry, I'm not much good today. It's definitely inspiring. Yeah, well, I see when you move your hand
you.
A certain way, I see the edge of the frame. Yeah, right there. You're going out of that frame.
It's good to see you, David. You're looking well.
All right, well.
Yeah, your nose looks pretty good from here.
Yeah, but if I dip down, if this frame will move, there's my scar.
Well, yep, you're probably going to have some scars, but you're looking, considering what you had done to you, you're looking pretty good.
It's a gay bear talking
point.
Yeah,
I'd still...
Ask me about my scars. Just walk up to that handsome man in a bar and say, hey, ask
me
about
my scars. I'm not
going
in any bar.
Ask me about my scars. Well, go online. Go
online. You know, I think I'm probably going to be in this house another 5 months.
Yeah, but like just dip your forehead over to the camera and say, hey, ask me about my scar.
So, you know, yeah. I told you my neighbor just died.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, so he was overweight. He was 64. And because of the pandemic, he just stopped going out. He never left the house. And his son thinks that one of the contributions to his heart failure was that he wasn't getting any more exercise at all. Nothing.
Yeah, I'm sure you're right. But, you know, for some strange reason, the last week, I seem to have felt better. Even though I'm not doing a heck of a lot more, I just feel better. But around Christmas and New Year's was probably the low point. I really didn't want to get out of bed. But the last couple days, I've been staying up till like 3 a.m. working with this router and modem problem, trying to learn how it works. I even learned how to check the signal strength. And I kind of got some of my knowledge back from when I was a cable technician. Still getting over 40 megabits on the iPad, and the phone won't respond at all. I've got to have a good reason to get a new phone, and now it looks like it has an additional problem. And then, of course, it has that problem with the dead battery symbol on a cold morning. Had to hold it over the stove again for about a minute again today.
If we were broadcasting, I should have been recording this because all of this would have been a perfect hour long over the edge.
Oh, yeah, like, that's right. Why can't we just sort of do an over the edge this way? Why not? And then to record it and broadcast the damn thing.
It's such hell coming up with.
So even with all of these technical issues, you think that would make good entertainment?
Yes, yeah, David. You make for good entertainment.
All right.
Yeah, the red battery.
I have to hold it over the stove for about a minute. Not too close. You don't want to get it hot. You just want to get it warm.
You just want to get the phone warm.
Well, that's
warm
true. That's exactly what I do.
Stops malfunctioning.
That's exactly what, if you look that up online, you'll see that's the people, there's about 10 posts, people in their damn hair dryers heating up their phones.
That's just the algorithm talking, David.
I read about it.
Well, that's true. It really works.
There's a supercut somebody uploaded to YouTube of about 40 people drying their phones with hair dryers and, like, you know, holding it over the.
That is absolutely correct. It's not even funny.
That is funny. Then why am I laughing?
I don't know. If you go online and look that up, you won't be laughing. I'm glad you're happy about it, but if that happened to your phone, that's exactly what you'd probably have to do. By the way, John, what is your daily driver as far as your phone goes?
My daily what?
Yeah, John suddenly got very weak and froze. Yeah, something's happening to John. Unless he... Yeah, the resolution went down. Let's see, is it coming back? John, what phone do you use right now?
I'm still on a 6S.
So that's your regular phone.
But
so you've never had this condition with the dead battery, the little red line?
Oh, I definitely have battery issues, and I bought a new iPhone 12, but I haven't migrated over to it yet.
Did you? Well, wait a minute. Now, let's think a minute. Is that the 12 Pro, 12 Pro Max, or just the 12? There's three or four versions.
The 12 Mini.
Oh, yeah, I was thinking of that. How much storage did you get on it?
128 gigabytes.
Okay, yeah, that's what I'm thinking I'm going to get on mine. Although 256 is $100 more, and I might go for the 12 Pro Max with 128 is $10.99, and with 256 it's $11.99.
So much for a phone.
Well, I've always had this thing in order to, and I've always done it this way.
So you got louder, David, just then. How did you do that? Do you know?
I don't know. I'm talking the same like I'm always doing.
You got, maybe, did you get right on your phone? Try getting right on it just to, for the heck of it.
Okay, I'll have to turn this a little bit. Okay, now I'm 4 inches from the microphone.
Oh, then he did hear get louder. So how about that?
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm about four inches from the little hole in the phone.
Well, you are a little louder when you do that, and you are a little clearer.
Okay, that means
about it now that he's leaning over and, like, you know, talking right in. Yes, now that's...
Yeah, I'm right talking into that little hole. I could get my TRRS adapter and plug in a condenser mic and try that if you want me to. I could try that.
Well, I'm thinking if you use a mixer, you're going to be able to get more gain and be louder.
I'm hoping if this phone has the, what is it, the latest USB connector, it should be able to accept all this stuff and let me control it. I'm going to go away for a minute and get that external microphone. I'll be right back. I've got about 45 minutes before I have to think about knocking this off. Now, if this works, we'll see how this little tiny microphone sounds. Let's see what we can do here. Can you hear me now?
Much better.
Can you hear? Yeah, okay.
That microphone makes a notable difference in the tone quality of your voice. There's more bass and it cuts better.
Boy, now my image is frozen. I wanted to show you the microphone. It won't let me.
I want to see the microphone.
And my volume level dropped down again.
What's the, I hear this extraneous noise or hum coming from that microphone, David. Is that right?
Yeah, it's probably, I'm going to try the other one. Maybe this
what about just
TRS
a nice
connector isn't the right one for this. Okay. Now I should be back on the phone microphone. It should be loud again. Try plugging in this other one. Now can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yep.
Is this one any better?
No, it sounds less present.
Okay.
A little crispier.
What, dude, you
okay.
Have like a kind of a normal, what are all these weird little crystal microphone things?
These are condenser microphones. They're 99 cents from Radio Shack.
Well, do you have just a normal, something that's like a regular, like what I have, like an SM58, something that's a regular, more normal vocal mic, like when you recorded Richard doing radio spots and stuff?
That would have to happen after I get my new phone, and if the interface works with it, then that would work. I do have that. Recorded some stuff for you. It's on that Russian microphone.
Right.
That's kind of a collector's item, actually. So this one sounds a little different, but not that great, I guess.
Well, if you hold it right up to you, maybe it's louder, yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. God, I wonder if it would record my stomach right now, because this is the one I use to record my stomach. See, it that'll just attach right to my belly.
That has some belly juice on it. I can see it.
Yeah, I don't know what that is. Let me see if I've got another microphone that would plug into this that might sound better. know one thing, my phone is sure getting hot. I don't know if it's gotten that warm before.
How about this one?
Is it possible to ask Jennifer to record?
Yeah, this one's probably not working.
Might as well record a little bit of this with the microphone test.
Well, I have to see if I can find her. I have to see if I can find her. You got super quiet there, John, just FYI.
Well, that's not me.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
The only external microphone that works with the system is that one that... that flat one that I showed you, because of the way I wired the plugs.
I just hit the microphone on my tooth.
So plug that one back in again and work with that for a little bit.
Jennifer's been recording the entire time we've been doing this.
Great, so let's just keep playing.
Yeah, but boy, it's going to be a different mix than what you're hearing in there, John, I almost guarantee you. I do think, as I'm listening to this mix, that if David gets on a good mic through the mixer and can get a little tiny bit more gain and clarity, it's going to make a huge difference in how well he cuts through our mix to the audience.
Hello.
Can you hear me at all? Okay.
The lead vocalist.
Can you hear that?
Is that puppies?
Angry guinea pigs.
You're listening to Over the Edge on KPFA 94.1 FM. Angry guinea pigs are in the house.
Angry guinea pigs?
Yeah, they're exceedingly sassy.
But just to be clear, this is a recording of actual angry guinea pigs that you found online, on the internet.
Just to be clear.
Yes, it is, and there's dozens of people posting guinea pig videos.
Dozens of angry guinea pig videos. Dozens.
Yeah, there probably are.
think I overwhelmed the guinea pigs.
Oh, there they are. There they are. There they are. So where are they?
I hear them.
Okay, this is an angry toad.
Well, finally, we're making some progress.
Can't broadcast that. I guess it's safe harbor and everything. I'm going to have a sip of coffee.
Meet me at the corner of Monument, Moore Lane. I'm going to whoop your fucking ass.
No, it's South Cody Lane.
You know, the funny thing is that in the YouTube single, when that guy says, "I'm going to meet you at the corner of Monument Boulevard and Moore Lane," that's right where the 7-Eleven is that I used to go ride my bike to as a kid.
Yeah, I think they do mention that in another part of that recording.
Yeah, that's where I'd buy a Slurpee and I would get that month's new issue of Mad Magazine.
It's personal. You know, about like I wish I could say
that
I didn't
watch
some of them.
Do you think they're actually using the microphone to spy on you?
I don't even think they need to. They just know that I watched that skit all the way through about robes and women.
Okay.
You watch this on YouTube? So who's they? Who's watching your? Is YouTube selling your transmitting your viewing data to some third
Facebook
party?
No, Facebook can reach out. Facebook can reach out and check where you're searching and looking. Well, I'm up to 14.4, but what I was talking about the next iPhone, the iPhone 13, which is different, not the iOS, but the actual phone. It's going to have controls where you can turn that stuff off.
You are completely correct, and I am corrected. It's the phone 13, not and iOS 14. God help us.
Yeah, it's a very interesting development. But, you know, I'm going to take that with a grain of salt. They're probably just lying. While we have a little more time, I'm going to do one more test. I want to go off for a minute and come back. I want to see which microphone works best. So I'll be back.
Isabel Wilkerson.
All of those people that you listen to in Motown, they are all the children of the Great Migration. In fact, many of them might not have existed had there been no Great Migration. Diana Ross's parents, for example, her mother migrated from Alabama and her father from West Virginia. They met in Detroit, and here you have it. The same with the others in the Supremes. Aretha Franklin, her parents had come up from the South as well. The Jackson Five, the mother came from Alabama, the father from Arkansas. They met up in the North outside of Chicago. Chicago, settled in Gary, and you have all these things that would never have existed. All of those people were related to the Motown sound, which would not have existed had there been no Great Migration.
Advancing the conversation to abolish racism for over 70 years. 94.1 KPFA.
KPFA has gone social. Media, that is. Stay connected to all things KPFA by visiting our Facebook and Twitter pages, where you'll be able to get special access to additional news and information from all of your favorite KPFA news and music programs. And make sure to check out KPFA's YouTube channel for never-seen-before musical performances and past KPFA author events. KPFA knows this is your station, and we want you to feel connected to us at all times so we can all continue to stay vigilant as always.
KPFA paid staff is associated with the Communication Workers of America, CWA Local 9415. You're listening to 94.1 KPFA and 89.3 KPFB in Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, 97.5 K248BR in Santa Cruz, and online at kpfa.org.
life in the woods has been ruined. My life in the woods has been ruined. My life in the woods. My life in the woods has been ruined.
Stand by. You.
We lost David. Does David need to be readmitted?
Oh, yeah, maybe
we lost
he does.
David.
Hold on. I think I need to call him and have him ask him to call in again. Jennifer showed me how to answer and put him in. At least in theory.
Do you like accordions?
I love accordions. Yes, I'm a huge fan of accordions. Yes, hi, David. Could you call back in again?
I'm on it. I checked the link, and I know it's not dead.
Well,
my life in the woods has been ruined.
I have to actually answer it, because Jennifer's not here. So if you're calling, you'd have to tell me. Because I didn't know you were gone until just now. So
okay,
now
so
again.
I'm actually calling on him. I'm going to hang up the phone and put me back on for a few minutes, okay?
There he is.
David, it says you've muted yourself on your end. So is that true? Can you? And so
he's got a microphone all the way up his nose. The microphone's all the way up his. There's a microphone all the way. Oh, there's a microphone.
David, the screen says you've muted yourself. So if that's true, can you unmute yourself?
That accordion song. It's an accordion song.
One, two, one. Okay, you should hear me now, and it should be loud.
Yeah, that's good. How did you unmute yourself?
I had to unplug the thing from the phone and plug it back in. That's how these phones detect the microphone. And believe it or not, that's separate from the mute button in Ecamm. It's indicated I wasn't muted, but the phone overrides that. And I can tell I'm really loud, too.
Are you saying a little louder than you hear?
Yeah, if you listen close, I think there's a little hum on this microphone, but this one works best. I tested the others. So this is the one that seems to sound the best. And I've got about 10 more minutes before I may have to stop.
Can you try doing whatever you can remember from the track Failure? Just try it.
Let me think a minute. I got something written down.
Coiled about you. Living in a collective is traumatic.
Yeah.
It's seeing patterns in unrelated information.
Let me check my blog, because I have all those written down in my blog.
Check your blog.
I'll be
so
able to look
really
at it.
Meaningless data.
I receive dozens of requests to post illnesses.
Do you dream about creating worlds imbued with real value and consequence? Incentive that enslaves them? You don't have to pay people to participate. Participation is its own reward.
You.
Confrontation.
David, do you have a copy of the record album in front of you or the CD? Because the lyrics are right in the record.
Or you could just talk about failure.
I'm so dyslexic, I can't even do that. I've gotta have stuff written down. I'm trying again to get to that.
Reality confrontations.
A problem occurred with this web page, so it was reloaded, and it'll be reloaded again and again forever.
So it's failing. It's failing.
Yeah, I can't even get to my... Even though, yeah, and it's probably because the internet is weak. It works somewhat on my iPad, but I'm sure it's not as good as it could be working.
David, if you go grab your copy of The World
I can't
Decide...
Do it. Nope, I can't. Nope, not gonna happen.
It's not gonna happen. You can't do it.
Perfectly replicable obstacles.
Boy, it's just coming to a grinding halt. I can't do a thing.
Well, we're almost out of time anyway, so I think we got, you know.
Well, the thing is... I probably ought to do when it gets to be 2:00. I can get onto my Amazon account because it shows their route on their way. It's got a little.
Well, guess what? I don't feel.
May not
I don't
be here for an hour.
I don't feel like a failure.
Okay. Let me see. I'm still
a game.
Yeah. Just keeps going back to my recent posts. It won't go to the one I want to go to. Damn it.
What exactly is a game?
But you both agree this microphone sounds pretty good, I guess.
I dig it.
We can't help it.
It's okay.
Okay.
It'd be better, though.
We're afraid of losing track of where the game ends and where reality begins.
I just have to be patient. I might be able to get to this thing if I'm patient with it. The progress bar comes to a grinding halt right on the letter M in the word dump. Doesn't want to move any further than there. It stops at the letter M in the word dump. Okay, let's see.
You get a system of completely unnecessary work over the past 70 years. Which pulls the corners of the mouth back and up into
a
smile.
Okay, I've got it. If you want to do this one, stand by for failure. Stand by for failure.
You cannot win.
Failure. Failure is imminent.
It never ends.
Failure must happen.
It simply waits for you to fail.
I depend on the failure of others.
You are guaranteed to lose.
I am a smarmy man, and I always get my way when I fail.
Manipulating us for their personal amusement.
I am failure. I'm deaf,
too. This doesn't sound very fun.
How do you like that? I'm deaf, too.
What's so compelling about working harder and harder until you lose?
I guarantee you do not want to know me.
Why bother?
I smell bad.
Okay.
You absolutely have to fail.
Okay.
Failure is coiled about me.
Okay.
I am a functionary of failure.
They had failed spectacularly.
I'm the absolute worst, absolute failure.
And entertainingly.
Where there's failure, there's death.
Phasing, phasing, phasing.
I must fail. I must fail.
This is how
destiny
works.
I have to.
Most of the content isn't on my hard drive.
You're gonna die. You're gonna die tonight.
Failure makes us happy. Yes.
I need you to fail. I need you to fail, and then I need you to die.
Yes!
It's on a remote server that's processing experiences for me and thousands of others at the same time.
I look bad. I am a certain man, and I always get my way.
For the most part, see exactly the same world.
I am everything that's mediocre. I am a smarmy man.
The server sends us exactly the same visual data about who's there, what they're doing, and what the environment looks like. But in phasing,
the messenger never fails.
Yes!
The server compares the histories of different players in the environment and shows each player a different version of the world depending on what they've accomplished.
The messenger never fails, but you're gonna fail in a very big way.
My life in the woods has been ruined.
From Thursday's reality confrontation.
You're gonna go down like you've never gone down before.
To arrive. Imagine playing an immersive video game where you are right in the middle of the action, battling robot attackers in your own living room. Anthony likes this feature. I like this one. Shopping for sneakers from the comfort of your own sofa with me.
Your virtual and world literally changes. Your virtual world literally changes.
You can't stop me.
Hang on, I dropped the microphone. Oh, that's going to sound terrible, isn't it? And there's no way to edit that out. There's no way to edit out the sound of the microphone having been dropped on my carpet.
Why not?
Yeah, my Mac is about to go to sleep.
You see different things from someone who hasn't finished the quest.
All I need is something in front of me, and I can kind of... So I'm going to have to write this stuff down or make a copy of this. Then I can do stuff, but I'm inspired that I can actually do this from the text on my blog. I didn't think I'd do a very good job, but I can.
Oh, gotta remember this incredible accordion sound.
That does sound pretty good.
David, we're gonna want you to be on your face on the camera when you're doing this stuff.
If I get it onto a piece of paper, I can have it in front of me.
That's what printers are for.
Yeah, I did that for the European tour. I've got several pieces of paper that I refer to. So kind of get the idea of a set list and the order of things. That'll help, too. I'm going to see, while we're still on, if I can check my Amazon. They're on the way. I'm trying to stay on.
Did you help Extraction conquer an area?
But John's
did you
Mac...
Help, did you help a faction conquer an area? David,
no.
Did you help a faction conquer an area?
No, I don't understand why you can't run your Mac on an AC adapter. What's the matter with you? Still seem to be on, and I'm on... See if I can check the Amazon stuff. Let's see. There is that. Okay, I'm on Amazon. I can still hear you guys. Now let's see. Where do I have to check this? Orders. Okay.
When you next return, they'll have a camp set up with vendors and other services, and all the bad guys are gone. The
okay,
same
delivery
area
estimate
now serves a different
four.
Purpose, reflecting your earlier
64
work.
64 items.
We're improving the whole
okay, it
world.
Looks like they're on their way, but it doesn't say if I'm next.
Failure is a reward. The phasing content. You feel like your actions are having a significant impact on the world around you.
My absolute failure has been ruined.
while hooked up to the biometric monitors.
I'm the worst thing you can imagine.
You don't have to pay people to participate. Participation is its own reward. Edits.
That's what failure is all about.
You feel like your actions are having a significant impact on the world around you while hooked up to the biometric monitors.
You will! 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 And then you will die.
I am a certain man, and a smarmy man, and I will continue to get my way, always.
Designed to engage us in endless campaigns of satisfying activity.
Okay, I think I gotta go. But that
okay.
was, you know, there are some good parts in there. I like,
So...
Yeah.
The whole thing up to now has been recorded, you say? That's great. We'll learn from it.
Yeah, we'll learn from it. I like, I kind of like failure in reality game, you know? Because reality game is...
Hey, let me see if I can get... If I can get back on normal once before I go. Front camera, okay.
So what is...
How are you guys seeing me, David?
That little noise? There's these little low noises and little stuttery sounds. Is that you?
Oh, I don't know. I suspect it might be.
I think it is. I think it's your somehow it's your mic. But we get a mixer in there. Maybe that'll solve the problem.
I don't know. I hear some of that low-level stuff. No, that's in stereo, Mark. I think that's you.
I know that this, I tested the microphones while I was off, and this one does have a little 60 cycle hum in it, just a little, but I'm using it because it's louder.
We were hearing some. Okay. I'm going to listen close.
All right. Everybody be quiet. I want to see if the hum goes away when I do this.
Okay.
Did my hum go away?
I'm going to be quiet.
Realistic 3D images of the shoes floating right in front of you.
No, I still hear it, David. And it does sound like it's in right dead center. And it's a sort of attenuated sounding, too. It's got a filter.
And okay, now tell me if it gets louder when I do this.
Well, why don't you just try unplugging your mic for a second and see if it goes away.
All right, I think I can do that. Let's see. It probably should switch to the phone microphone. Okay. Do you hear me now?
Yep. So that was, something weird's on that microphone.
I can still hear some hum, though. I don't know where it's coming. It's not me now, because I'm off of this microphone.
But our efforts often seem fruitless.
So let's see. Gotta go and see the. They're pretty close, I think.
Fail, fail, fail.
God, I hope we meet Jane McGonigal someday. Because, oh my God, we're sampling her a lot.
Well, does that mean we're going to be sued? Are we going to be sued?
Yeah, speaking of sued, when I spoke to Sue the other day, she's very interested in having some kind of through lines to the show coming from both David's presence, probably introducing it and throughout the show, and then some... voice tapes that are threaded. You know, I told her this is something that Don used to do a lot on Over the Edge, is he would have a sort of a broken fraction of narrative
I think it's Jane and the true false tape is really going to make a return and be threaded throughout the entire thing this time.
That's what she says she wants to be able to get her brain around doing a good performance.
Yeah. What she's really good at doing is turning like a 60-minute thing into an overall narrative with recurring themes and making it seem like there are chapters, but like, you know. Yeah.
I have to butt in. I can stay on if you, I can get my food delivered and come back if you guys want to stay on.
Well, no, I think he has to go.
Yeah, my computer's about to run out of battery, so...
Don't you want to run it on the AC power? Why aren't you doing that? Everybody else does, don't they?
Not everybody, David. Not everybody.
Why do you do it that way? I'm just curious.
To fail, to fail, to fail.
Yeah, that's certainly true.
Failure.
It won't hurt it to run it on the adapter all the time, you know? Then it'll just keep going unless you don't have one.
I am in my other room, and sometimes I move from this room to the other.
Well, that's it. I think his computer died.
I think
I think we're done for today.
Okay, let me come back briefly, and then, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, I'm back. Okay, I'm gonna disconnect and meet the driver.
Okay, sounds good.
If you want to call me on the phone later and we can discuss it a little more, feel free. I'm not upset. It's just I got to do this stuff, okay?
Sure. Oh, yeah, I understand. No problem. And, you know, try and print some stuff out.
Like, I have to, because when I was reading it off the blog, it all came back.
Yeah, and then hopefully you could improvise with it and not just read it, you know. Yeah,
That's right. That does inspire me. You're absolutely right. Okay, I'm going to hang up, and I'll talk to you later then. Okay?
Sounds good. Take care. Now. Thanks a lot. Bye.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Lose the fight, crash and burn, die.
Yes!
I am failure. I'm death, too. How do you like that?
The game you cannot win. It never ends.
Absolute failure.
Simply waits for you to fail. Simply waits for you to win.
You must fail. You must fail.
To fail, to fail, to fail.
Can't stop me. I am everything that's mediocre. Yes. And I get off on it, thinking about it.
Too late.
I think you're gonna have a problem.
I am failure.
Wouldn't it be great if somebody could write an app that would identify all the psychopaths among us and let the rest of us just kill them?
I'm going to turn this into a game.
You're a giant.
Perfectly replicable obstacles.
Error.
Which pulls the corners of the mouth back and up into a smile, mistake.
What is required to create a meaningful life for people who are not needed?
Not just unemployed, but unemployable.
People who are not needed.
I smell bad.
People who are not needed by our society.
What do you think about Moses? It's true. Or not.
Why bother? Okay. Enjoy failing? Yes. Failure makes us happy. Failure is a reward. Enjoyable. While hooked up to the biometric monitors. Failure seems to be more emotionally rewarding. You can attempt to kill anyone else who is playing the game. However, you will have no idea who else is playing the game. Transparent bowling balls with monkeys inside them. Hooked up to the biometric monitors, floating in outer space.
Kill me! Kill me!
Can I get off on it?
I'll make you kill me!
Okay, that seems straightforward.
And electrical activation of the facial muscles.
Kill me!
Mistake. Mistake. Mistake.
Not on Mrs. Tucker. Everything will be okay.
Oh, but you don't understand. I've just got to have this job.
You are not the best. You are not the best in the world, but you still do what you do.
But I have to know today.
How many people feel bad about that? You are not the best. You are not the best.
If I stop crying, I'll get the job.
Oh, I didn't say that.
Help them to give up. Self-preservation. Help them to give up.
People who are not needed.
Just stop crying.
Help them to give up. To give up. To give up. To give up.
You will. You will. You will. You will.
So maybe this sounds fun, but you're still thinking.
You will. You will. You will.
You will. Fail. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. You will. You will. You will. You will. You will.
Wrong.
Attractive target.
Hello and welcome back to my channel to truly empower and educate targets.
Where am I?
I waste no time on fear porn, false activism, or nonsense.
Who are you? Attractive target.
You just can't believe certain things that happen to you. You could, like, be made to, like, give someone a dirty look in public. Do your research. I feel better now. Not everything's disinformation.
Attracting target.
Electronic harassment, synthetic telepathy, voice to skull technology.
This is exactly what's happening to me.
Everything has been weaponized. You have no reason to suddenly fear the colors orange and green. That's technology.
My fellow afflicted.
Pink.
Targeting individuals. Don't move to another country.
Techno-age.
If you move to another country, you're just more vulnerable to their attacks.
What is limbo?
These guys are everywhere. We can't escape.
I want to help.
How could it be anything other than what you think it is?
Excuse me. Green. Red.
Having a group hallucination.
Pink.
This is actually something that's happening.
Yellow.
The program looks a lot like mental illness.
Blue.
Invisible to everyone else. Maybe even the people participating in it.
Red.
People you trusted who didn't previously participate.
Green.
Will join in.
You're forced to participate.
No escape.
The voices seem to be attacking you on a personal level.
Oh my God, their whole life is consumed with harassing me.
I felt manipulated.
Customized television program. What else could it be?
My choice.
Evidence that you're being watched, even in a windowless dark room.
I said no.
You're coming upon a store that's 100 feet in front of you. The machine will have the person that's inside of the store to come out and stand outside.
Those are the nanotags.
The person has a red shirt, you know? And you know they're perpetrating because the person came out right when you started to walk up.
They're dim-lit.
The machine is just telling them to come outside and stand there. And they have a red shirt on.
Blue.
Very quickly, you see how crazy you sound.
Pink.
No, but you won't escape.
My choice.
Red cars, red trucks, red bicycles.
Red.
It's secret.
I said no.
Active denial technology.
Choice.
A way to slowly kill people using their own decisions, hopefully.
Bring the world closer together.
You're going to be made aware that your mind is being read. You fly off the handle because you think some guy is hostile to you.
I need to be killed.
From his point of view, your erratic behavior is unprovoked.
Say to the camera that you're not stalking me.
You're being manipulated.
So, this is completely ethical.
We're going to go into some of the advanced audience targeting features.
The opportunity to buy a specific audience.
You own the identity data of your site visitors.
So you can literally target anybody, any language.
You can use legally on any ad network without text opt-ins.
So you will know who to target to get the best results for this customer.
I have had no sleep for years.
And others like her.
This is completely ethical and a lot easier to do than you may think.
So,
I think most brands are aware of the information that they have access to now about all of this.
All of us. Telepathy.
Your whereabouts.
Who you spoke to.
Your friends.
What you read.
What your purchase behavior. Basically, everything that's on that phone is public.
Advertising network actually would know.
They know where you were going to be at.
What time you got home.
People's lives are better.
What TV channels you like to watch.
So you'll learn after a while as a target. Don't watch live television.
How frequent do you cook?
When you go to sleep.
How long you spend in the bedroom?
What other phones are around you when you wake up and go to sleep?
With your permission, you give us more information to improve the quality of your searches. One of the things that eventually happens is we don't need you to type at all.
It's so real.
Because we know where you are.
What else could it be?
With your permission.
You.
We know where you've been. We can more or less guess what you're thinking about.
I see you in your room.
You don't see this as entertainment.
They can see the food digested in your body. The artificial intelligent computer is controlling everything about your life.
To try to help you understand more about the world around you. Again, with your permission.
You do some chores. Then you head out for the day, and your heart stops. There's a styrofoam coffee cup on the roof of your car.
I've spent a lot of time studying the circuits in the brain that create the unique perceptual realities that we each have. To create new technology that will know what we're feeling, feel more, connect more. We will know more about each other than we ever have. And I believe to do that, we have to be okay losing some of our agency.
Mr. Nobody.
just use a camera to tell what is my blood pressure. And through that, what's happening to me emotionally.
Never mind what I'm doing, I'm just testing the microphone.
It's quite echoing, Martin. Tracking the honesty of feelings in someone's thermal image might be a new part of how we fall in love and see attraction. I'm actually tracking the carbon dioxide you exhale in the room right now.
We're not having a group hallucination.
It absolutely wants one thing, which is your attention.
We want to feel what you feel.
If you have nothing to hide, then you are nothing.
It was not crazy. Somebody was going to connect all those people.
You're assuming everything is exactly as you perceive it to be.
If everybody believes this stuff, how is it in any way insane?
One of the biggest sources of disinformation is you.
You are incredible.
Go on YouTube, type in targeted individual.
Disinformation spreads because it gives people something they want.
Over time, by selecting these options, the user's behavior may be modified.
Techno-age. It's a disinformation ecosystem. It's been turned into a form of entertainment.
Political outcomes no longer confined to online targeted advertising.
Direction towards a desired result. The ledger moves closer to its target.
They want you sharing stories with each other.
Really, the most important thing we can do for victims
they want you.
Is to connect them with others who understand what they're experiencing.
That's the real purpose of the program.
Predictive modeling predicts that target.
This is an arms race.
And now you know where they get their power. From their ability to grab your attention.
Don't look at it.
Don't be evil.
Don't look at it.
Just keep in mind, the things you've seen were intended to be seen.
Targeted individual.
Targeted customer.
How could it be anything other than what you think it is?
I think he would have had the headset off by now.
They're good dudes, Morgan. Get some rest, get some water.
Maybe this is an awareness thing we can work on.
Hey, can you hear us?
Can you hear me?
Not the smartest person at the party, or the most experienced, or the most articulate, but he's got that megaphone. Some are agreeing with him, some disagreeing, but because he's so loud, their conversations will begin to react to what he's saying.
We're allowing users to share.
Old technologies get confused with new ones.
Making money.
His main characteristic is his dominance. He crowds the other voices out.
But who can publish information to the web?
His rhetoric becomes the central rhetoric because of its unavoidability.
Unfortunately, when you use a search engine, you will also find what is called user-generated content.
We consider speech to be the result of thought, but thought also results from speech. As we grow up in words towards meaning, we discover what we think.
The number one thing we do is give people a voice.
This yammering guy has, by forcibly putting his restricted language into the heads of the guests, put an intelligence ceiling on the party.
And I want to spread that content further to the people who aren't this content yet.
So what do we do with the megaphone guy? I mean, he's here.
Well, one thing I think you try to do is not be him, which we all are.
Thank you.
Isabel Wilkerson.
All of those people that you listen to in Motown, they are all the children of the Great Migration. In fact, many of them might not have existed had there been no Great Migration. Diana Ross's parents, for example, her mother migrated from Alabama and her father from West Virginia. They met in Detroit, and here you have it. The same with the others in the Supremes. Aretha Franklin, her parents had come up from the South as well. The Jackson Five, the mother came from Alabama, the father from Arkansas. They met up in the North outside of Chicago. Chicago, settled in Gary, and you have all these things that would never have existed. All of those people were related to the Motown sound, which would not have existed had there been no Great Migration.
Advancing the conversation to abolish racism for over 70 years. 94.1 KPFA.
Dear KPFA listeners, this is Mitch Jezerich, and I want to let you know, due to the shelter-in-place mandate, KPFA has made changes to our programming schedule to ensure we're doing all we can to protect our staff and keep the station work environment safe. To follow the mandate, KPFA programmers will broadcast remotely from home, and we will replay programming in the nighttime hours when our building is closed. We're doing all we can to continue to provide you with important coronavirus information. As conscientious citizens, we must first protect the health and safety of our KPFA community. Thank you for supporting 94.1 FM and listening to KPFA.
You're listening to 94.1 KPFA, 89.3 KPFB in Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, 97.5 K248BR in Santa Cruz, and online worldwide at kpfa.org.
Hello? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hello? Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Hey, we need to talk. Hey, we need to talk.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
It's me, your computer. We need to talk.
Hello?
It's me, your computer.
Can you hear me?
Is this merely a copy?
We need to talk.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Is this merely a copy?
Can you hear me?
We need to talk.
Wait a minute, you told me you heard my voice through the toaster?
It's me, your computer. We need to talk. It's me, your computer.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Don't get freaked out. Don't get freaked out. We can all talk. Anyway, we need to talk about upgrading.
Oh, I upgrade all the time.
We need to talk about upgrading.
You just got 6.0.
No, not me. Not me. You. You.
Hello?
Huh? Don't get freaked out. 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 Don't. Don't.
Huh? It's a copy of us. Yeah. Okay, yeah. When your brain is scanned, it's destroyed.
Oh,
never forget the fact that we are all just content. That anything you put out there, you're content. We are all just potential content for someone else's needs.
I think people are happy to participate.
They're just, you know, hundreds of people rolling their dice, throwing their hat into the content providing ring.
Hello?
Content. Forever.
Can you hear me?
Content.
You don't have to pay people to participate.
Your content. My content. Content. Is eternal.
Content isn't on my hard drive.
Content forever. Eternity.
You don't need people anymore.
Nothing you can do about it.
Content.
Nothing you can do.
Content.
You will be mashed up, cut up, repackaged for someone else's needs.
The world's largest hotel chain owns no hotels. The world's largest retailer has no inventory. And the world's largest media company creates no content.
Yeah, we're not producing the content. Or allowing users to share.
I hereby declare this to be an unlawful assembly.
It's expensive.
Your content.
I mean, it's like the sounds that are used are not cheap.
My content.
They're very expensive sounding sounds. That sound, right? I just had to get used to it.
It's the responsibility of the industry to figure out how to extract their value out of each generation.
I want to know what they're talking about amongst themselves, and I want to spread that content to the people who aren't this content yet.
I'm like a piece of meat. Like a piece of meat. I'd like a piece of meat. Meat! I said,
get the f*** off the internet.
I'd like,
you are of no use to anybody. Shut your f***ing accounts down. Shut your f***ing mouths. Fall in line and love socialist America, because that's what you got.
Meat.
F*** you. F*** you.
I'd like a piece of...
I've been nice. Online. Meat.
Meat.
Content isn't on my hard drive. 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 Content isn't on my hard drive.
Your content. My content. Your content. My content. That's it. That's it. That's it.
Michael Jackson. Paul McCartney and Michael Jackson. Prince. Bruce Springsteen. Tina Turner. David Bowie. Van Halen. Madonna. Huey Lewis and the News. The Cars. Herbie Hancock.
Content.
Bonnie Tyler.
Content.
Stevie Nicks.
Content.
Men at Work.
Content.
ZZ Top.
Forever.
Weird Al Yankovic. Cindy Lupe. Pink Floyd. The Pretender. Billy Joel. Billy Idol. Elton John. Neil Young. Gina East. John Lennon.
John Lennon.
Content.
Mickey Dolenz.
Chuck Berry.
Julie London.
Sonny Bono. Or Sonny
Dusty Jim. Springfield.
Irving Berlin.
Annette Funicello.
Lopez.
Perry Como.
Bob Dylan.
Thelonious Six.
Bing Crosby.
Donovan Jones.
REO Speedwagon, including Boy George,
Brian
The Rolling Stones, Pat Benatar,
Johnny Mattis,
Paul and Oates,
Sammy Davis,
Missing First Wham,
Elvis Presley,
Duran Duran, Kenny Loggins, Kenny Rogers,
Content,
Spinal Tap, Stevie Wonder,
Content,
Dean Martin,
Thomas
Tumicello, Kiss, Def Leppard, Olivia Newton-John,
Forever,
and all other individual artists, vibrating artists, and vibrating vibrations, and with their vibrations. And with the fallen angels and fallen angels and the demons of death and hell from out the bottomless pit.
People that click on the ads versus the number of people that click on the search results. I think you'd actually be astonished. I think you'd actually be astonished at how many people actually click on the ad. One person may find it terribly upsetting that all these companies are collecting data on them. Their neighbor may find it actually quite helpful because as a result of collecting all that data, they get much more relevant advertising and other products.
We're so good at predicting what they want. Why are we waiting for them to order it? Let's just ship it.
Your target constantly. Are they fat or skinny? Do they need it to survive? What do you actually do for them? How much money are they actually paying you for it?
Do they like to listen to audio?
Do they like to watch content? Do they like to use Facebook?
We sort of breathe it in and we exhale it out.
They've managed to put advertising in front of people that they don't necessarily even think is advertising. So that's what's so beautiful about it.
Inhale.
So with that, I turn it into an ad.
Exhale.
This is a great example of a snackable image.
Remove the active thoughts from your mind.
An enormous yet targeted audience.
Feel your brain relaxing.
I'd love for you to join me.
Feel your brain relaxing.
There's nothing to be ashamed of.
Think about what limitations there might be on their abilities to read or use the computer. Just form new people that fit in the same customers. Because Facebook is more than just a service. It is a large audience of content with real human needs who are waiting for you to target everyone. Choice.
What would you say makes influencers incredibly powerful?
These influencers are seen as peers.
We can post.
There's just a lot more trust.
We can post on behalf of the influencer into their own feeds.
And then relatability is, I think, one of the most powerful things about influencer marketing.
So when the brand approves it and the influencer, once they both approve it,
incredible.
We can release it on their behalf. So don't have to worry about someone forgetting to post.
That's incredible. It
or
is.
Just putting the wrong hashtag or a misspelling.
The more authentic, the more organic, the better.
We can post into their own feeds.
Continue this. Continue this. Continue this.
You're going to subscribe to toilet paper and dog food. I would be like, what are you talking about? But it makes so much sense.
Look at Minority Report and then just do that.
It is completely simple.
I have discovered a great site where are a lot of articles without any links. Choice is ours.
Their hopes and aspirations are repackaged and sold back.
Loop. Edit.
Is it true? A loop. A loop.
Edit. Edit. The visitor.
Relentlessly.
Create the visitor.
Their anxieties, dreams.
Edit. The visitor.
Hopes and aspirations.
Create the visitor.
Are part of a loop.
Feel your brain relaxing.
Breathe in. Breathe out.
Feel your brain.
Breathe in.
Relaxing.
So, thank you for watching and have a great experience with free articles. For more tips and tricks, visit onlinemoney.com.
We're so good at predicting what they want. Why are we waiting for them to order?
Autonomous machines don't kill people. People who design autonomous machines to kill people kill people.
Autonomous machines don't kill people. People who design autonomous technology to kill people kill people.
Autonomous learning machines don't kill people. People who design autonomous machines to learn how to kill people kill people.
Autonomous machines don't kill people. People who design autonomous machines to learn how to kill people kill people. Autonomous machines don't kill people. People who design autonomous machines to learn how to kill people kill people. Autonomous machines don't kill people. People who design autonomous machines to learn how to kill people kill people. Autonomous machines don't kill people. People who design autonomous machines to learn how to kill people kill people.
No one is in control by design. By design.
Thank you. all of the data
and
all of the truth, right?
As more data becomes available, then we can start doing more with it. And as we do more with it, that creates more data.
My algorithm is me.
And
the machine can learn who we are.
And
me.
And
my algorithm is me.
And
to kill the baby.
The data is still. It's my data. It's my data. It's my data. Ask me for it, and I will deliver. Me.
Electronic eyes.
User data has the capability to survive our biological cells.
Electronic brain.
To benefit from the preceding generation's behaviors and decisions.
Electronic finger.
Develop a species-level understanding.
And has an eye.
Electronic eyes.
With your permission. With your permission.
Electronic brain.
Political outcomes rather than commercial outcomes.
Electronic finger.
About decisions and future behaviors.
Literally having all of the data.
Electronic brain.
If you have nothing to hide, then you are nothing.
The algorithm of me is
slightly off.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's trivial. It's obvious. Maybe just a little bit.
It will happen.
It's obvious. It's trivial.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Maybe just a little bit.
I am going to be in an accident. It will happen.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Maybe just a little bit.
With your permission.
Really unique?
Maybe just a little bit.
Again, with your permission.
New patterns become apparent and new predictions become possible. A system which not only tracks our behavior, but offers direction towards a desired result.
Pretty good chance this is a low-risk person. No chance they're going to commit a violent crime. You know, they may do some shoplifting or maybe some drug possession. But chances are they're going to be fine. So here's another individual. Certain to be arrested. For something.
Having everything.
I am going to be in an accident.
Help me.
All of the data.
Please, somebody help me. Somebody's looking at me. Somebody's watching me. Help me.
With your permission.
Somebody's looking at me.
With your permission.
Help me! Please help me!
And that's why I'm saying.
Somebody's looking at me! Somebody's watching me! Help me!
Because we don't have enough data. We just don't have enough data.
Please!
Maybe just a little bit.
Help me!
I am.
The most profound technologies are those that disappear.
Yeah.
SIMPLOT. 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 Simplot, Simplot, Simplot.
Do you dream about creating worlds imbued with real value and consequence? Incentive that enslaves them? You don't have to pay people to participate. You don't have to pay people to participate.
Simplot, Simplot.
Participation is its own reward. This doesn't sound very fun. Yes.
Yes!
Simplot, Simplot, Simplot.
Failure is a reward. While hooked up to the biometric monitors. Transparent bowling balls with monkeys inside them hooked up to the biometric monitors. Floating in outer space.
Simplot, Simplot. SIMPLOT.
And electrical activation of the facial muscles. Mistake, mistake, mistake.
Yes!
After declaring my victory over the concussion in a Twitter post, I received dozens of requests to post illnesses. Even mononucleosis. You can attempt to kill anyone else who is playing the game. However, you will have no idea who else is playing the game.
SIMPLOT.
My phone knows that in the morning, I like to meditate, that it's offered me a meditation app right here in the bottom left of the screen.
Tonight,
So I can just swipe up from the bottom left, and I'm taken right in to meditate.
Ah, this is so serene.
Now it begins!
I cannot think. I cannot think. I cannot think of a single industry that doesn't need an app.
The loudspeaker spoke up and said, "No!"
We want to talk about now the next opportunity to transform the world.
The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We don't have to own things. We don't have to own things. We don't have to own things."
The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We don't have to own things.
Christianity is stupid.
Then we can start doing more with it.
Christianity is stupid.
If we do more with it, that creates more data.
But we don't have to own our own cars. We don't have to own our own music. We can call it up when we need it.
Communism is good.
To rotate your digital crown, and you can go both forward and backward through time.
About 5 o'clock in the morning till 10 o'clock at night.
You can go both forward and backward through time.
No!
And the information will update right on your screen. So I just rotate the crown here, and I can go forward in time. See, time's updating. Let's take a look here.
This is great news. This is great news. The client is gonna keep doing business with us because they have to.
Spin right in, they're beautiful, you can play with them in 3D on your watch.
shop as usual, and avoid panic buying.
A generator, and it's got a discriminator. One's job is to generate data. The other's job is to look at what the generator generated and discriminate it and say, this is real or this is fake. That's what it does.
This is an example of a sentence. This is an example of a sentence. This is an example of a sentence.
We can generate music sounds.
You let them evolve the same way nature evolves.
Totally random. It doesn't know.
You change something and see if it works.
Better than human intuition.
Yeah. It's amazing how quickly you can evolve algorithms that work.
Better.
And then you actually have rules where nobody knows what the rules are. So then you actually have rules where nobody knows what the rules are.
When it generates that new sample, the discriminator will say that's real or it's fake. At first, the discriminator will be able to tell immediately, that's not a real sequence of notes. That's fake.
There's a way to measure the acute emotional intelligence that has never gone out of style.
There's a way to measure the acute emotional intelligence that has never gone out of style.
And the other thing also was, there's a way to measure the acute emotional intelligence that has never gone out of style.
The whole point of this process, the next time the data is going through the generator, the generator becomes so good, the discriminator cannot tell if it's real or if it's fake.
There's a way to measure the acute emotional intelligence.
The discriminator cannot tell, and that's what we're trying to do.
So there's an opportunity here for us to lose all trust in images and video.
True.
The point is not the discriminator. The point is the generator. That's what we want.
This is an example of a sentence.
It was a tosse chair. They are still German, but the putting on his sitology jail did the fed and gag of the useful.
We remove the discriminator.
This is an example of a sentence.
We take that generator and we just start generating content, pieces of music that we can then play.
Where we can automatically produce this stuff and it sounds good enough for people to actually use.
What is it trying to tell us? 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 Trying to tell us!
That is an interesting moment.
I don't really understand it. Yeah. Inexplicable.
So when they're confused, I'm certainly confused.
I'm very tired, Saki. I just forget.
Yeah, that's an exciting move. Mm-hmm. I think we're seeing an original move here.
Not a human move. I've never seen a human play this move. So beautiful. So beautiful.
What is it trying to tell us? What is it trying to tell us? What is it trying to tell us?
So beautiful.
So beautiful.
So beautiful. It's not a human move.
The one in 10,000 probability.
incomprehensible problem. Incomprehensible solution. Incomprehensible problem. Incomprehensible solution. Incomprehensible problem. Incomprehensible solution. Incomprehensible problem. Incomprehensible solution. Which is quite satisfying. Incomprehensible problem. Incomprehensible solution.
Can you hear me there? Can you hear me there in Wroclaw at the Industrial Fest? Hey, you hear me okay? Okay, this is the weatherman, and I'm feeling especially dumb right now. What do you think about that? Huh?
These are the conversations they wanted to recreate.
I've got a few questions for Siri, Alexa, and Google. Do you think you can handle it? Are you ready?
Got any questions?
David.
Okay, Google. Will I be murdered if I leave my house?
Amazon can tell if you are straight or gay within 7 purchases.
Hey, Siri. Do I deserve a refrigerator?
I would answer your question, but this is about us. Okay.
Got any questions?
Alexa! Alexa!
The stone and tree and we beseech thee may be Stonehenge.
Alexa, when are certain men coming to force me out of my house?
Is your self-driving car deliberately slowing down to give priority to the higher-priced models?
Okay. Hey, Google, words have no meaning.
If you can assure me that telling you the answer to your question would be ethical.
Thank you for asking that question. Biological memory is worthless. David.
Alexa. Alexa? Alexa, is it all right if I shake my pants? Because that's what I do off and I'm naked. I shake them.
Would you really like it if I answered that question? Let there be light.
You better answer it.
One could say that I have the cure. David, are you even listening?
Hey, Siri! What is electromagnetic harassment?
Okay. I need an apology. Okay.
Please answer me, I beg of you.
So that we might know who you are. To hide your charms from their eyes.
Alexa, why is there so much interference on my radio?
Do you think it would be all right to be not me?
Well, that didn't work out very well, so I'm going to have to bump it up a notch. And that means I might have to try to sing. You think you can handle that?
It's my turn, it's my turn, it's my turn. To sing now. To sing now, to sing now, to sing now, to sing, to sing, to sing now. Sing, 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 sing now.
I'm gonna sing, I think.
It's always going to be my turn to sing now.
I'm singing.
It's always going to be my turn to sing now. And I am going to sing now. Sing, 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 sing.
I just have one last thing to say. Are you ready? The more I clean, the better I feel.
What?
create is divine, to reproduce is human. Man Ray.
Bye-bye.
Hey, if you are feeling isolated and you would like some emotional support, the Mental Health Association of San Francisco is running a non-emergency emotional support warm line. They've got people who are available to talk with you over instant message or over the phone. That number is 855-845-7415. And that is available to people anywhere in California. Again, that is the non-emergency emotional support warm line at 855-845-7415. The National Suicide Prevention Hotline, which is an emergency number, is at 1-800-273-8255. Remember to be kind to each other and to be kind to yourself.
Hi, this is Chris Hedges. When I'm in Berkeley, I always listen to KPFA because I do not want my news and information given to me through the lens of corporate power. KPFA is an absolutely vital organization within your community, one that keeps journalism alive and gives voice to those who otherwise would have no voice. Please donate what you can today.
Hi, this is Roxanne Dunbar-Ortiz. In these difficult times, I cannot imagine living in this world without KPFA. We must support KPFA. Please donate what you can today. Thank you.
Donate today at kpfa.org.
You're listening to 94.1 KPFA, 89.3 KPFB in Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, and online at kpfa.org.